You go out of your house and want to power on the computer remotely, then how? There are two methods to do that. You turn on the computer from anywhere, from there remotely access it. For example, here I have a smartphone using mobile data, I use it to power on the desktop remotely. Then I access the desktop via smartphone. I introduce two different methods as follows. Method 1. On the target computer you access UEFI BIOS. In this case I use ASUS motherboard. You find the same feature on other motherboards. Advanced. APM configuration. I set the computer to automatically turn on after the power is restored. Restore AC power loss. Power on. And here is a smart power plug. TAPO. Mini smart Wi-Fi socket. You can control this smart plug from anywhere. TAPO P100. And here is the price of the device. TP-Link TAPO P100 Mini Smart WLAN Socket. What it looks like. Above. Bottom. A power button. You can turn it off or on manually. Here's how to control the smart plug. On your phone, you install an app called TAPO. The app name is the same as the device name. TP-Link TAPO. TAPO app. Continue. You create a free account. Log in. Log in. Allow the app to send notifications. You can disable notifications if you want. Skip two-step authentication. I use my phone to connect to the wireless network on the smart plug. Tap on the plus sign. Add device. List of supported devices, quite a lot. Plugs. Tap OP100, right at the top. Observe the LED on the device and go to the next step. Enable Bluetooth. Connect the power phone and power plugs via Bluetooth. Allow. Allow. Touring on Bluetooth. Enable. Skip. I don't want to share location. Pairing. Pairing. The smart plug is scanning for wireless networks around it. You connect it to your home's wireless network. I connect the power plug to my wireless network. Name your device. Next. Where to put the device, which room in your home. I select the default icon. Final setup steps. The device has been added to the app. It will be managed by the TAPO app on my phone. I try to control the device with my phone. Off. On. Now I connect the smart plug to my desktop. Remote control. On my phone I use mobile data. 4G. On. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. The computer is on. Successful. Not only that, I can disconnect the computer from the power source remotely. Of course, you shouldn't turn off the computer suddenly like that. Method 2. Method, what is the difference between method 2 and method 1? I use an expansion card to control the computer on or off. Smart switch. Computer power reset switch. Work with Amazon Alexa. Work with the Google Assistant. Work with 2IN. Its components. Manual. Expansion card. FAI PCI. Connecting cable. Antenna. 2IN Wi-Fi Smart PC Power Reset Switch Remote App Controlled. There are two different cables. Expansion card. Two cable connection locations. Connect this cable first. The cable has a male end and a female end. Connect the cable to location 1. The cable has two female ends. Connect this cable to location 2. You should not confuse the two locations with each other. Fei PCI. Screws. These are the three screws that come with it. I wonder why the seller did not pre-install the components together. So I do not have to do these steps. But that's okay, it's quite interesting. Antenna cable. Connect it here. Desktop. This is the cable that connects the motherboard and the button power. Disconnect them. Power switch. Male interface. Connect position 1 to the power button on the computer case. Connect them like this. The other cable I connect to the motherboard. The previous position I connected to the power button. The expansion card is located between the motherboard and the power switch. Install the expansion card. Fix the expansion card with screws. Screws that come with the device. And finally the antenna. An antenna is needed to connect to the wireless network in your house. Adjust the antenna direction to optimize the connection. Next is the application to control the expansion card. You use an application called 2iA Smart Life. On the smartphone I install an application called 2iA. Agree. Log in. On the device there is a button called Wi-Fi config. On the first use you press this button and the LED will flash. While the LED is flashing you add it to the application 2iA. It's time to add the device to the application for remote control. Computer. Add. Connect the device to your home Wi-Fi network. Processing. Added successfully. Done. Now I can control the device with my phone. I test by turning on the computer remotely. 4G. The phone uses mobile data. Power on. The CPU has spun. Successful. Here are two methods to turn on the computer from anywhere. From there you can access the computer remotely, work remotely. Thank you for watching. Good luck.